I am Dora Domajnko, development engineer at RLS. Today, I would like to talk about the importance of precise mounting of the encoder. RLS's magnetic encoders are high-precision instruments where each function is carefully addressed by engineers to optimize the measurement result. That's why we are often downright disappointed when we find that customers only experience limited performance due to sloppy mounting of the encoder. Let me explain why you shouldn't stop adjusting the mounting just as soon as the magical LED indicator turns green. Each type of encoder has some of its own tips and tricks, so we will only go through some examples of misuses. Most RLS encoders comprise two parts: magnetic carrier, ring or scale, and the read head. Let's start with the mounting of linear scales. The mounting area should be flawlessly straight. If there are any bumps, the ribbon will follow the curvature of the surface and thus seemingly prolong its path. If you paid extra for our finest scale with 5 micrometers per meter accuracy, why waste all those microns on uneven surface? Magnetic scales with stiff frames are less sensitive to bumps, but the final accuracy can still be reduced by unparalleled mounting. In this case, we are measuring the length of hypotenuses of a triangle while moving over the cathode. This is called linear error. Linear measurements are also highly influenced by temperature changes because the scales are subject to thermal strains. Systems with multiple track magnetization, linear or rotary, can be falsely mounted upside down. Of course, functioning is not possible in such case. Magnetic rings are mounted on rotating shafts. If the shaft is too thick, the ring will not fit on it. If the shaft is too thin, there will be an air gap between the ring and the shaft. This is why we have to prescribe such tight mechanical tolerances for the shaft, because otherwise the ring starts dancing around the axis of rotation. This produces the so-called eccentricity error, which is often the greatest proportion of overall encoder inaccuracy. Eccentricity can be avoided by centering the ring with a linear touch probe. Some products also have an option of auto-calibration of eccentricity error. Another problem which may occur during mounting of the ring is tilt towards the axis of rotation, or wandering. This causes measurement errors of radial encoders and unstable reading distance of axial encoders. Wandering can also be avoided by using the touch probe on the upper surface of the steel flange. Finally, let's talk about mounting of the read heads. The far most important tolerance here is usually the distance between the read head and the surface of magnetic material. Why? Unlike light, which is used by optical encoders, magnetic field fades very quickly with distance. The band where magnetic field strength is optimal is extremely narrow, in the range of 100 micrometers. The read head is calibrated at that optimal distance, so it is very important to mount it there and also keep it stable during the full revolution. There are also prescribed tolerances for roll, pitch and yaw of the read head, but I will intentionally skip those today just to make sure that you first remember about most important ones. Keep your scales straight, your rings well centered, and always check the reading distance.